God here. And she named that child Ichabod, saying, the glory is departed from Israel, because the ark of God was taken because of her father-in-law and her husband. And she said, the glory is departed from Israel, for the ark of God is taken. Right before you sit down, look at the neighbor and say, neighbor, where is the glory? Amen. You may be seated in the house. God bless you, my dear ushers. You may have your seat. Where is the glory is our text for today. As we begin to look at our world and our current situation, you wonder now what in the world's going on. Seems like people are running and hiding in caves, and we are afraid of what's happening in the world. But we have no reason to be afraid of what's going on, because why? First of all, this world is not our home.
That's right.
We're just strangers and pilgrims passing through. How many realize we have another land? We have another opportunity because God has been good to us. As I begin to preach on today, amen, for just a little while. As we begin to look at our particular text, how many realize it shows us that we are responsible?
Yes, sir.
As children of God, we cannot remain silent.
All right.
My. We're just as guilty as the people who are pushing and shoving this stuff down our throat. But we don't speak up for God. Thank you. I'm going to hit somebody. Look at the word of God. Amen. In our text, it says, oh my God, here he tells us the death of Eli. Eli was the prophet. He was the prophet for Israel, judge, for 40 years. But how many know he had two bad sons?
Yes, he did.
He had two bad sons doing whatever they want to do and call themselves priests. They were doing what they wanted to do in the priesthood.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it wasn't saved, but how many know they were ministering to people?
Come on.
Aren't you tired of being people with their collars turned backwards? Calling themselves brothers and sisters and calling themselves preachers and sleeping with everything they can sleep with.
All right.
I ain't looking for no amens in here today.
Right.
How many know they're just doing what they want to do? And how many know the bishop won't sit them down because they're his children?
Well, I ain't
gonna have no help today. But as we begin to look at it and dig deep into the word of God today, the prediction. How many realize the earlier chapter of Samuel predicted this? The prediction, how many know, because at time people run to church when they need something. And they run to church and they cry out to God and they cry those crocodile tears for about an hour. Then they go back into the world and do exactly what they always done. How many realize, but they will assure that God will make a way because I went to church today.
Yeah, all right.
The prediction in the foregoing chapters concerning the ruin of Eli's house here begins to be fulfilled. As I begin to look earlier, you know, because my pattern is when I started with the conjunction, I have to go back up. Look at the second verse. And it says, and the Philistine put them in array against Israel. And when they joined battle, Israel was smitten before the Philistine. How many realize a lot of people are losing battles because why? The priesthood has been compromised.
Yes,
churches have been infiltrated.
Yes.
How many realize that they're allowing in and everything to come in church?
Yes.
What are you saying, Pastor? Not that they're coming in church, but they got office in the church.
Yes.
The deacon brothers ain't never been blood washed.
Oh.
The preaching ain't never been called. And we wonder what's going on.
Yeah.
My goodness, here I'm talking here. Israel suffered defeat because the priesthood had become corrupt. The people were living in disobedience to God's commandment. They took the Ark of the Covenant to battle, thinking that how many realize because they took the Lord's Supper last week, that they're going to be all right this week. Because they got baptized. Y'all know where I'm going. You go into water, a dry devil. And you come out what? I mean, the water didn't save you. You just took a bath. All you need was some soap. I'm preaching just like this today. But they took the ark. How many know they have the audacity, Hophni and Phinehas, after they were doing what they want to do? And I mean, realize they just grabbed the ark of God and walked the presence of God into the battle. And when the presence of God came into the battle, how many realize they start shouting, yeah, we gonna win. But haven't lived nothing all week long. And expect because I called God, he's supposed to come. How many know God ain't no sickle boy? You got to have a relationship with God, my God here. People just think they can just put him up want to. But how many of you got to have a relationship with God? In this house today. But look at the text, amen, as we begin to look at it. How many realize that the ark represents God's presence in Israel? Woo! The people thought that the ark would unconditionally guarantee God's favor and power. How many know some conditions go with this? Yeah, never likes today. How many of you got to have some? It's something that you have to do. You have to have a relationship. Nobody, no stranger can come in your house and just go through your house without, you know what I mean, somebody letting them do it. You're not going to allow no stranger to walk through your house, go wrap in your eyes box, say, hey, girl, what you got up in here? No, 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 because you didn't have no key. And only people that are allowed in this house are the one I gave keys out to. You can't court the devil all week. And then start thinking you're going to be still married to Jesus.
All right.
I got a word for you today.
That's the word.
Oh, my goodness, here. Where is the glory? I see so many people stuck on positions. How many know God didn't call no titles? We worried about what's our status in church. But how many realize that we're living in a time that it means war? How many know the devil is trying to take us out? Devil's not worried about all the other stuff. But when you declare that I love the Jesus, he saved me. How many know that all hell breaks loose in your place? Oh my God, here your dogs start acting crazy. People around you start acting like they ain't got good sense. And you wonder, what's really going on? How many realize that we call the attack of the enemy? As I begin to preach on today, but as I begin to look at it, can I teach it here? The disgrace, look at the word, the disgrace and the loss of Israel sustained in the encounter with the Philistine. First of all, their foolish project to fortify themselves by bringing the ark of God into the camp upon the shoulders of Hophni and Phinehas, which made them secure, struck fear into the Philistine for a minute. How many know that the devil knows who's real or not?
Amen.
Devil ain't scared about you because why? You was on the pole last night.
All right.
Ain't got nobody helping here. You was all up in the club, hey. Oh. But how do you realize that stuff don't work? Then now because you in church, because you drunk too much and you got a hangover, and now you got all kind of issues, but the devil is alive. If you want to play with something, go get you a toy. You can't play with God. I'm preaching in here, Lord. Ooh, they should have shouted in Sunday school. But look at the thing. The fatal consequences of it. Israel was beaten and they are taken prisoner. Ooh, they grabbed the presence of God in an ark. Took in prisoners. How many know the tiding of the thing brought to Shiloh? It was sad. And how many realize that Eli, when he heard that his sons was dead, how many know that Eli was grieved? But how many realized that it didn't kill him? But when he heard that the presence of God was taken, the Bible said that Eli fell backwards, broke his neck. Oh my God, he died with a heavy heart. But how many realize what the important part of this text is, time fails me to go through it all, is the fact that his daughter-in-law, Phinehas' wife, was about ready to be delivered. And how many realize that when she was delivered, her husband was dead. Her brother-in-law was dead. Now her father-in-law is dead. And now she brings forth a son. And the lady down that's helping her, the midwife, said, be of good cheer. It is a man child. Hallelujah here. And she was not happy because of the loss of the ark of God. How many know when we lose God's anointing? When we lose the presence of God, then we lost it all. I'm preaching now, brother. I don't know it yet. How many realize when we lose the effectiveness of God to be a child of God? How many know that all of your life the devil has been trying to destroy your testimony? He has been trying to kill what you say God is about to do for you. The devil can't stand you. He hates you. He wants to destroy you. And if he can't get to you, you wonder why your children have lost their good mind. It's because the devil can't get you, so he'll get to the thing that you love.
Yeah,
preaching already.
Yes.
So, in the particular text, hallelujah, here is the fact that when she brought forth the son, and Eli was dead, she called the son Ichabod, meaning the glory has departed. I've been in a lot of places and it seemed like they used to shout over in the Holiness Church. They used to testify to the goodness of God. People used to come to church sick and leave that well. People, you didn't have no money, no food to eat, but they believed to trust in God. I'm reminding of an old mother said the Lord told her to get up and boil some water. She said, Lord, I don't have nothing to put in the water. But how many know, because you said it, she put a pot of water on the stove. And about time the water was at the boiling point, somebody knocked on the door and said, the Lord told me to bring you a feast grocery. Tell your neighbor, where is the glory? Anybody just glad not that I'm a superintendent? Not that I'm a president, not that I'm a bishop, not that I'm this thing, but I'm just glad to be on the Lord's side. I don't know about you, but I still love the song. I don't want no peanut butter and jam, but all I want is my soul to be saved. Is there anybody in the hope today? Just glad you're saved. I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody about somebody. Where that God being gun was. And how many realize they put no